It's time for some Python on hardware. So here we go. This week, some newsletter stuff, and then I'm going to play a video. So I'm just going to quickly go over the news. Raspberry Pi's new OS. This is called Bullseye. It's named after characters in Toy Story, but there is a bunch of features
yes,
that you can...
And things probably broke a little bit, too. They always do. Oh, yeah. So just be chill, everybody. You can always run the older version of the operating system when you do. I mean, I love that they release code. I don't ever want them to release new software. However, just be aware, we don't get the software any sooner than you do. So if stuff isn't working, just post in the forums or let us know on Discord or open up issues on GitHub, and we'll do our best to, you know, get things working and fixed up. It's Linux, so it's always an adventure. That said, do check it out and let us know if you do find something that stopped working.
Okay. Scott was on Tom's Hardware and showed some of the CircuitPython on Raspberry Pi. There's a really neat LinkedIn Learning course that has CircuitPython specifically.
Sharon.
Yeah. Then you can meet the maker, Liz Clark from Blitz City DIY.
It's Liz.
That's right. And then ZDNet top programming languages. Python is right up there, along with JavaScript, as expected. So you can check that out. It's added Python, that is, added 2.3 million developers to the community in the past 12 months. Hey, guess what? If you learn Python, you can do hardware now. I showed off, this was part of the thing that Scott's working on. I showed off this HDMI e-ink display just because it made it even weirder what we're doing. One of our missions is to keep it weird, and I hope we're fulfilling that.
That's weird.
And then you can check out the rest of the newsletter. There's a lot of stuff this week. We have a goal of like 10,000 subscribers, so check it out on adafruitdaily.com and sign up. And if you like it, tell friends and all that stuff. We don't spam. It's a separate site. All those good things, we wouldn't do that, so you don't have to worry about it. Isn't it nice to go to a website, too, like adafruit.com, and there isn't this giant pop-up?
I know, there's no, like, your cookies and your...
And then when you leave the website, there's not some weird automatic email that says, hey, you have stuff in your cart.
I miss you.
So, you know, there's lots of ways to support companies that do that.
You can have an ad blocker on adafruit.com, and we don't care.
Yeah, it doesn't do anything.
Because it doesn't do anything, because we don't have any ads.
So, next up, Trevor... Our lead iOS developer is working on this cool thing called PyLeap. He's working with our team on this, and he has a cool demo, and I'm just going to play it, and that'll be our Python on Hardware news for this week.
Hello, this is Trevor, and I'm here to show you our new app called PyLeap. PyLeap basically allows you to collect files and libraries from the Adafruit Learn system for specific projects. And then you'll be able to transfer them directly to your CircuitPython Bluefruit board without opening a code editor or connecting to a computer. Let's get started. Here we go. First, I'm going to put my CircuitPython Bluefruit into pairing mode for a quick process. There we go. And we should be connected now. There we go. So we're going to pair it to our device. And here we have three example projects set up. The first one is Glide On Over Some Rainbows. So here we're going to download our project. We're going to download our project bundle here. And just like that, it's downloaded. And here we'll send it over. And that's that. Some beautiful rainbows. All right, let's try the rest. Here we're going to do a simple blink example. I'm going to download that bundle, send it over, and here we go. Our second playground is blinking pink and purple. All right, now let's send over some rainbows to our LED glasses. So let's download our bundle. Download it. There we go. And send it over. This should take about 5 seconds to send over. But when it's done, here we go. No code needed. All pre-written. All right. That's the demo. Thanks for watching.
And that's Python on Hardware News.
Blinka, 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 blinka. Thank you, Blinka.
Okay.